Looks like there's no one around anymore to enforce this.
I found a dig site that is fenced off from view. What were they doing here?
A gray hand said he left his materials behind. It should be somewhere around here. They look relieved to have finished their work. This is the kind of brain trouble my mom warned me about. The work at the dig site has something to do with Day Zero. There's a big tree with a researcher's notebook inside it somewhere. Memories and emotions condensed into a mineral. I wonder what this channel is for. They must have already shipped out all the harpic they need. I wonder what's on this reel. What is Day Zero? Maybe I can find out more about it.
necessity of day zero is not just psychological, it's ecological. Because there is a compounding effect to these minerals and their psychological effect. And we see this in Tiang Valley. There is a memory and a memory of a memory and a memory of a memory of a memory. This echo effect, this recursive nature is the problem. As this cycles through the ecosystem, it creates points of pressure where things bleed, and soil and human minds are contaminated. Some will say, what's a few daytime visions? But it is an increasing risk, an increasing danger. Left alone, the haunted quality of this season will only get worse. The necessity of day zero is also to... This particular action will neutralize this phenomenon at its source. This is not an endless cycle. We are putting an end to this psychoactive material, and we are opening up space for something new.
How do they plan to remove the haunted quality of this season?
The necessity of day zero is not just psychological. The necessity of day zero is not just psychological, it's ecological. Because there is a compounding effect to these minerals and their psychological.
They dug up all that harpic in order to conduct some sort of prayer on day zero.
I've recreated the same setup as the prayer statues right here in my workshop. I set up a singing bowl so I can verify the pattern that will form in the water. And some harpic, of course. Each god seems to correspond to a resonating frequency. And when this vibration acts on the harpic, we get the psychoactive response. Going to give it a try here.
Watching my dad make shadow puppets on the wall. Felt strange because I could see how it was done. I could see the trick of it, but it still felt kind of magical.
It do feel the more I do this, the more tired, and it feels like it takes me longer to return to the present. But now I have some control. I face the question of how this mineral affects the soil. I still have a lot of work to do. That's all for today.
A mineral that can affect the mind. The Grey Hands present one side to the public, and another is hidden behind metal fences. There is no one to oppose them. There is only my record of what they did here. The memories of the owner now turned into a beautiful mineral. What we do to the land eventually makes its way into our blood and our brains. This can define a season.
The info sign earlier said they are dangerous in large numbers. I didn't, though. In Cairo, we have a statue to remember Dr. Fumio. But this statue is meant to be worshipped. This field was absolutely full of memories. I'm glad I had my pendant, otherwise it would have been overwhelming. This is a season when memories echo on and on and on and on. Will the echoes fade away, or will they be cut off abruptly? The year of the Din? Was that how they recorded years in the olden days? Thank you.
These slips are prayers to this god for forgetting things. People prayed here. Who did they pray to?
Thank you.
I'm sure these critters will escape the valley before the flood. The Grey Hands have a lot of this stuff now, for better or for worse. The tree looks healthy. The ritual must have worked. Is this an organ? It looks like a musical weapon.
No, no, no! You said we had until midnight.
I'm not ready to leave. Look at all this. Wait a minute. A cute outfit, a bicycle. You're not a Greyhound.
Oh, what a relief. I'm sorry.
I just assumed because who else would be... What are you doing here?
Well, I'm Sofon. My boy Kochi is skulking around here somewhere. Welcome to Tiang Valley. You should have been here a week ago when the evacuation started. Almost everyone is gone now. You noticed, I hope, that the valley is going to be flooded. The Greyhands are taking us to live in the Radiant City. Look! See how they put the dimensions on the back? I recreated our future apartment here, on the lawn. This is the space we have to work with, to live in. I'm trying to really imagine what it'll be like. We're going from a big farm to one room. And we need to be packed by tonight. I already packed for myself and my son, but my husband Yuri is a little harder to pack for because he passed away recently. And I can't bring all his things. It's not realistic. His stuff is still... It's all here. It's okay. You said you wanted to meet people, right? Well, here I am. This lawn is my whole life. We can do this. Just need to decide. Thank you.
Yuri learned to paint from our neighbor, Matiora. He painted all three of these. This is a self-portrait he did. Kind of intense, right? He was more handsome than that. I wish he could have seen himself the way I saw him, you know? He was really lovely. Just occasional dark moods from his work. This is his portrait of me. We got into a fight over it. What's that supposed to mean? You just splatter some paint on the canvas and put my name on it? He said it was my essence. I don't know. Do you think it looks like me? He painted this for Kochi. Some kind of private joke between the two of them. I don't get it. They were both interested in the war and how it ended. I'm not. I just pray nothing like that will ever happen again. Which painting should I take with me? Yes, you're right. Himself, from his own eyes. Something I could never see without this painting. These are Yuri's books. They're pretty heavy. This is an old religious book, The Prism of Yesterday. He didn't like to talk about his faith. I haven't read it much. Maybe there's a part of him in these pages. A part I never understood, that I could still glimpse. Maybe he would want me to keep this one. But I don't know. It just doesn't mean much to me. Yuri found this old tourist guide to the valley before we moved here. He was so excited. But this guide is really out of date. It's from way before the war. There's something optimistic about the colors they used. Yuri really wanted to take a trip to the archipelago together. We prepared for it a lot. Even taught ourselves a bit of the language from this book. But we never made the trip. It was always going to be soon, but it never happened. Seems like the kind of thing no one does anymore. Which should I take with me? Yes, that seems right. Maybe I'll even read it one day. I suppose I'll be leaving the other two behind. I know they're heavy, but would you want to take one with you? Yeah, maybe you'll make it to the Azan Islands someday. All right, this is going well. But I feel like I'm forgetting something. Or someone. The demon of shame and mourning. How could I have forgotten? Now, where did I put him? We need to bring the demon of shame and mourning. When someone dies and you're in mourning, you're supposed to keep the demon in sight at all times. He's supposed to remind you of your regrets. It's a religious thing. Our old cart broke. I overloaded it. So I had to use the wheels of his bicycle. Now he's so mad he won't say a word. I've packed my essential clothes. I don't know what to do with these. This was Yuri's best suit. Maybe when Kochi grows up, it'll fit him.